Morning, students. Today, we are going to see about the characteristics of human rights. Rights arise only in society because they are the results of social nature of man. Without society, there can be no rights. Let us see the society. Rights arise only in society. When man began to live as a human being in a society, when man began to live in a social order or in society, the rights emerges because they are the results. Rights are the results of the social nature of man. Without society, there can be no rights. So this is the first characteristics. And the second one is, a claim of an individual is not a right. A claim of an individual is not a right. To become a right, the claim should have the recognition and acceptance of the society as a whole. A claim, what do you mean by a claim? A claim by its very nature implies selfishness. This claim may harm the interest of a person or persons in a society. So, by that only the rights, on other hand, aims at good of all. For the welfare of the society, only rights are recognized by the society, sanctioned by the government. And these rights have a moral end to serve. Moral end to serve. And next one, the rights are compatible with the common good. The society gives recognition to only those rights which are for the welfare of the society as a whole and which promote some common end or moral good. That is, the rights promote some common end or moral good. So the rights always aims common good. For these rights only the society give recognition and the state promotes. So the next characteristics, the state does not create rights, though they exist within the state. The state does not create rights, though they exist within the state. The state simply maintains, promotes, and coordinates them. The state gives legal sanction to every individual. The state ensures to everyone the enjoyment of his rights. Rights must be definite and universally applicable. The rights are universally applicable. They are given equally to all individuals. There is no discrimination on the basis of race, religion, sex, etc. If these rights are given to one section of the society, means it is not a right. They become privileges. And rights and duties are correlated. Next one is what? The rights and duties are correlated. They are the two sides of a coin and can never be separated. Each side has a meaning. Each side has a corresponding obligation. The rights of an individual become the duties of all other individuals of the society. We never think we are only having these rights. We have to respect the rights of others also. This is the duty. The rights of an individual become the duties of all other individuals of society. For that only, an eminent writer said, lives without duties are like men without shadows. They only exist in fairy tales. And the next characteristic, lives have a tendency to grow. Lives are not static. These are always changing. In a change in the socio-political economic environment needs of man, there is a change in social, political and economic and environmental circumstances. The needs of man also growing. The rights are also grow. Rights are also grow, develop and expand. And the Middle Ages, in the Middle Ages, right to life and right to property is considered as important. At the time of French Revolution, you know, in France, this French Revolution, liberty, equality and fraternity. This is the slogan of the French Revolution. These are all, the people also struggled for these rights, liberty, equality and fraternity. At that time also, these rights are given to the people and these are considered as indispensable. Indispensable means this is necessary. And modern times, the grant of social economic rights along with other rights in modern times, these are all not only the right to liberty, equality and fraternity. Now, we are enjoying social rights, economic rights, and along with other rights. This is the order of the day. And this is, these are all the characteristics. So rights have a tendency to grow. That's why the social, older social political orders, they recognize rights to a very small time, very small extent. In course of time, new rights have frequently came into existence. So this is all the characteristics. By these characteristics and this lecture, we are also going to see about the classification of rights. By this nature, by its nature, these rights are classified into moral and legal. Legal rights. Rights are broadly classified into two categories. They are moral and legal rights. The legal rights are further subdivided into civil and political rights. First, let us see about what are moral rights. Rights which are based on ethical or moral sanction of society are called moral rights. These moral rights do not possess any legal backing. It cannot be enforced in any court of law. Cannot be enforced by court, any court of law. And the moral right, the moral opinion of the society recognized the rights of children. For example, the moral opinion of the society recognize the rights of children, and it is one of the rights of the child that he or she should be protected by his or her parents. If the parents do not pay due attention to the children and thereby violate these rights, they cannot be forced by the law to comply with this requirement. So the moral rights have no legal sanction. They, if in case the parents neglect their children, there is no legal action for the erring parents. The moral conscience of the community expects that the moral conscience of the community expects a young man to look after his parents at old age. The moral right of the parents cannot be legally enforced even if they are discarded. That is regarding the child and regarding the parents. This moral right, the moral conscience of the community. The government is regarding the violation of the laws of the land, it can act regarding legal rights only. If any legal right is attacked, the government is involving in that matter. So a woman may become helpless. She is treated badly by her husband. It is a case of the violation of a moral right, not a legal right. This is the difference between the legal right as well as the moral right. And the next classification, legal rights. Rights, a legal right is recognized by the state through its law. It can be enforced in a court of law. In case there is a clash between the legal and moral rights, the former has precedence. The legal right has precedence. The legal right is important. So the legal right, if this legal right is violated, we should go to the court. For example, passing of the Hindu Code Act of 1954-56, according to this Hindu Code Act, women have a share in her father's property. If this legal right is violated, the aggrieved women can go to a court of law for justice. This legal rights further divided into two categories, civil and political rights. Let us see what are civil rights. The civil rights enable to lead a normal social life. The civil rights refer to those rights which provide conditions of a civilized life. The enjoyment of these rights facilitate the all-round development of an individual's personality. And what are the civil rights? Some of the important civil rights include right to life, right to property, right to work, right to education, right to speech, right to expression, right to form association, right to follow any religion, right to have a family. These are all the important civil rights which enable an individual to lead a normal social life. So among these civil rights, the right to life is the foremost human right. Life includes livelihood, food, clothing and shelter, and opportunities for unfolding personality. We have to develop our personality. We should have these civil rights. And these rights are available to the citizens of almost all the states. E.H. Green considers the right to life as the most fundamental of all civil rights, without which no life is possible. No right is possible. The next one is political rights. What are political rights? The political rights refer to the privileges of citizens which enable to participate in the political affairs of the state. And these rights are available to the citizens alone. Mostly, political rights are available under democratic system of government. The important political rights include right to vote. Those who attain the age of 80, irrespective of any difference, all must have the right to vote. So first political right is right to vote, and right to contest in elections, right to hold public office, right to criticize the government, etc. These are all the important political rights. Because of that only, human rights are a bedrock of your democracy. Through the exercise of these rights, the government can be made responsible to the public opinion. So, this political rights are paramount importance. They provide a basis for working of a democracy. Democracy is government by consent, public opinion, or public criticism. Such a government is not possible unless citizens are warmed with political rights. So, this is the classification of rights. Thank you.